Hello viewers, I hope you are well, and in today's session I will cover one functional aspect, which is reversal of a journal, and for reversal of journal there are basically two functionalities. One is both are out of the box, but the way of doing is a little bit different. So we'll explore. So I will just filter within a posted journal. First of all, I will find basically the journal which I need to reverse. So I will use contents and the batch number ID, and this is the journal which I need to reverse. I will show you the lines. So these are lines with the credit entries, and there is one debit entry in the last. Okay, so I just want to reverse this one. So there is one functionality out of the box, which is like reverse entire journal. So this can use whether you want to use existing date for reversal, or you want to use a new date sometime when fiscal year is closed. So you won't use the existing dates for reversal, means the dates which are available or entered previously on the line level. So if you want to do that, so just use this tick mark or checkbox. So what it will do, it will just use the same dates of lines, and just then put some command like incorrect entry or something like this, and then just press the reverse button. So it will reverse if the fiscal year is not closed. But what if the fiscal year is closed? So now if you can see, the status is also shown reversed, and the fiscal year, since it was not closed, so the transaction have been reversed. The ledger transaction with voucher number has been reversed. So it is already mentioning this voucher number has been reversed. So you can just note down this one, and okay, this is already noted, and just close this window. And how to trace that this is already this has been performed well? So you can just go to the voucher level, and in the voucher you can see there are three dot sign here. You can just go to the reverse tracing here. Okay, so you can just open it, and then it will show you all the overall journal. For example, here our voucher number was 803, so this was the voucher number, and all the negatives are credit entries, and this is a debit entry with a positive sign, and same with the opposite sign, like now this is debit entry, and the last one will be the negative or credit entry. So the voucher number new is generated of that sequence is different because it is a reverse voucher, or number sequence is different. So this is one of the way out of the box available in the system. But how about if it is not sometime it is not reversible? So there is another way. I will just show you. Just close it, okay, and also close this journal as well, and let's find some other journal. For example, might be 629 might be available. No, it is not, and let me just remove the filter, clear it. I will sort Z to A, and I will pick this 626. Okay. So fine enough, this one is another journal. So I will just note down the number, which is journal batch number 626. Just put here, no need of this, already done. And just open the lines. In the lines you can also note down the voucher number here. Okay, this is the voucher number, and it is the same for all the entries, and there is only one debit entry and the remaining are credit entries. So how to do it in a, with another way? So that one is also very simple way, but it won't allow you to, you know, change the new date to a new date, but it will load the transaction from this journal itself. How to do that? Go ahead with creation of a new journal, and journal type should be same like journal. Go to the lines, and in the lines you can see there is option functions available, and there is a load ledger transaction. What it does, basically it loads based upon filter criteria, whatever, for example, if you give a voucher or journal batch number, so it will load all the lines from that journal, and you can also invert the sign while doing it. So I will do as you can see, there is an option of which voucher number, how you want to give it a voucher number. So I will choose new voucher number per voucher. So means if there are 10 vouchers, but in this case it was only one. But if, for example, if there are 10 vouchers, so new 10 vouchers will be generated. So I will choose new voucher number per voucher, and there is a function available here called invert sign if you want to reverse it. If you don't want to reverse it, you just want to repeat the same lines in the postage journal, so in that case you can turn it off. So just do that, and then there is a filter option. There was a previously entered voucher. You just go ahead with filter option. Okay, and just clear this one, and for that you can also reset here at the bottom. It will reset the query, and then the voucher number which you have noted, just copy it, and here it will not be by default shown. So what you can do, either add another line here, and in that journal account entry you can go ahead and find the voucher which will be available. One moment. Yeah, it is available in journal entry, basically this table, and in this table the field voucher is available. You can just paste the voucher which I have copied and just press OK. Now filter will show the voucher number which I have just copied from here, which I need to reverse. Okay, and now I will also invert the sign. Why? Because debit need to be credited and credit need to be debit. So it will turn, it will keep it with opposite signs. So I will just press OK. After filter criteria is given, it will load the lines. Okay, now you can see here description is auto-filled, and it is showing that it is a void of that voucher, original voucher number. And now you can see on the left hand side a new voucher number has been generated. This one is not with a reverse voucher number or number sequence, but it is the same voucher number. So this is another way, and here you can see the dates are same, and whatever was debit amount is with now negative sign, and credit with negative sign means it will bring the opposite effect, that is a debit effect. Because why? It is in on the credit side but with an opposite sign. So this is another way, and so this is single entry system. It is not double, means on one line there is only one entry, either it is credit or debit, otherwise you would have used offset account here. So anyhow, after this you can validate your journal. Okay, it shows completed, and just note down this new batch number. This is a good practice if you want to do it. I mean, in the journal description you would want to, for example, give it like a description, sensible description like reverse of journal batch number, this one, and voucher, which one is that, originally this was the voucher, you just mention it for later tracing, and then just go ahead and post it. By the way, the lines already contain the descriptions, so that will also help. You know, here description is already included. So this is another way of doing the same thing, and I hope you must have learned reversal of journal, and I hope that I will follow some other reversal as well. For example, the credit note on purchase side or on the sales side, and that I will cover in future definitely, and more functional videos are upcoming. So just stay tuned, and please give any of the feedback or any of the topic if you want that one. But I will keep them short. So basically, if there is a lengthy procedure, I will split into bits and pieces, because that would definitely interest our viewers. So thank you very much, guys, and take care. Bye bye.